Hey, what's going on guys? My name is Alex and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to increase fan speed using SpeedFan. And as you can see right here, this is the software, and if you look in the left side of the software where it says fan 1 and fan 2, basically fan 1 is my CPU fan and fan 2 is my rear fan, or in other words the back fan of my computer. And if you have multiple fans working, it will show them right here and their RPMs. So let's start. Of course, I'm gonna leave the link in the description so you don't have to type it out in Google. And once you have clicked the link, click here about in the middle where it says SpeedFan 4.52, and it's going to start download. I'm not going to show you how to install it because it's pretty much straightforward. I do not need you to show that. And yeah, once you have first installed and opened the software, we will show you the welcome page, I'm pretty sure. And just click close, and right here where below configure, you will see by default automatic fan speed is going to be unchecked. Make sure you have it checked so the software automatically increases decreases the RPMs. So to increase the fan speed of your fan, just click configure right here, and then in the top where it has all of these options, go to advanced. Then in the chip section right here, it has only one. You need to click in the blank right here, and you will see 5 options. For me, it's 5 options. For you, it may be a lot more. If you have like 4 graphics cards, who knows, you will see 4 graphics cards. So what you need to do right here, you need to find your fan chip. That's my fan chip right here, my fan chip name. Yours is going to be different. I do not know it. Do not open your computer because this is where your fan chip is. It's in the motherboard. And yeah, you need to find the chip which has all of these options right here. If we go, for example, to my graphics cards, you will have only one option. So you need to find the chip which has all of these options right here. So if, as you can see right here, the PWM1 and PWM2, these are the two settings we're going to change. The PWM1 and 2 is the fan 1 and fan 2. As I said in the start, fan 1 is the CPU fan and fan 2 is my rear fan. So by default, the PWM1 mode is by default or to on or off, and if I change it to Smart Guardian, it will drop down the RPM. It will go about, I'm not really sure, yeah, as you can see here, it dropped a bit, but it won't drop a little, like 400 RPM, because I'm recording right now and cannot drop lower than that. I'm gonna turn it back to on or off. So look out in the fan 2 section where it says 1193 RPM. I did not know this back then, that my fan could go up to 1800 RPM. Back then it was going only to 1000 RPM. So if I change it to from Smart Guardian to on or off, you may look out in here, it will go to 1800. As you can see right here, went to 1300 and it will go to 1800. As you can see right here, 1753. I haven't seen it go above 1800. Maybe it has gone, I don't know. I'm gonna leave it to on or off. So that's what you have to do. Install the software, go configure, then go to advanced, then chip, find your fan chip, change the option to on or off, and you're done. So this is not going to be automatically on or off every day. You have to change it manually, because if I restart my computer, it's going to turn back to Smart Guardian. So make sure whenever you boot up your computer, go to software and turn it to on or off, and then click OK, and it's going to stay like that. It's going to drop like 10 to 20 RPMs, but it's not going to be a big deal. And if you are gaming very hard, if you are playing very intensive games, it will go above the limit, I think so. So that's a video guys, thanks for watching. If you have any problems, tell me in the comment section and I'll try to help you as much as possible. If you have any video ideas, tell me in the comment section and I'll make them in the future. Thanks for watching guys, like, subscribe and share, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!